Hello, good morning, and happy Friday, Maple Shade. Oh my god, Hashim, I can't believe it. It's Friday. Are you so excited it's Friday?
Very excited.
Oh, awesome. I love the energy. Okay, everyone, I am joined today by my good friend Hashim Hussein. We are here together. He is here because he has demonstrated already. We're only 2 weeks into October, and already he has been shouted out for demonstrating good qualities of friendship, because don't forget, October is Friendship Month here at Maple Shade, and for his reward, Hashim is going to be helping us out with the announcements today. So the first thing that we're going to do, Hashim, is we are going to rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. You want to help me with that? Sounds good. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may be seated. Okay, students, so one thing that I want to let you all know, you have been working so hard, and I don't know if you have noticed, outside in the hallway, you'll see a big bulletin board that has been put together by Mrs. Lohan and Mrs. Zito, and on that bulletin board, it is tracking our progress for ST Math. So if you want to know how we are doing with your progress on ST Math, you can always check that bulletin board. And when last I checked it, we were at 14%. 14%! That means we are almost there! Do you remember how much we need? I know, it's a pop quiz. 20. Good job! All right, Hashim, you are awesome. So 20%, we need 20%. And do you know what happens when we get to 20%?
Gigi's
gonna
come.
Gigi's gonna be here to have a good time with all of us at recess. So if we get to 20%, oh my god, it's gonna be so fun. So I wanna see Gigi, you wanna see Gigi, we all wanna see Gigi, so keep working hard at ST Math. You have got this. Okay, so I don't know if you remember or not, but the month of, from September 15th to October 15th, excuse me, is Hispanic Heritage Month, and we have been able to shout out and God bless you, and we have been able to shout out and interview and get to know some of our students with Hispanic backgrounds. And today we are going to talk to one of our good friends, Santiago Gutierrez. Santiago, come on over, buddy. Everyone, a big round of applause for Santiago. Santiago, say hello to everyone. So Santiago, if it's Hispanic Heritage Month, why don't you tell us a little bit about your own Hispanic heritage?
So my whole family was born in Bolivia. It's the heart of South America. My whole family was born, but I wasn't there. But my mom told me that I have the blood of Bolivian.
That is awesome. The heart of South America. That's a great way to put it. And what are some... Bolivian traditions, because, you know, the rest of your family, you know, had been born there and they came over here. So I'm sure that they carried some traditions from back home. So what are some of the traditions that have been kept alive in your house?
Like dancing, like food.
Dancing and food. So yesterday you were telling me a little bit about the dancing and what music is like in your life and within the life of your family. So do you want to talk about that a little bit?
So like when I'm in the car, we're going to like a place, they always put like a Spanish song that my sister likes it, but I don't.
Okay.
And my mom always like jams to it, but me and my brother are in the back just getting embarrassed.
Okay. So for your mother and your sister, and is it the same way for your grandparents as well? Like do they really get into music also?
Not very much, but I know my grandma did.
Okay.
Because she was a Zumba.
A Zumba instructor?
Like, no, not an instructor. She went to Zumba.
She went to Zumba, okay. That was, I mean, people that get into Zumba really get into Zumba, and they learn how to move. You said food. You said food is also a big part of your culture. So what elements of food, what do you like?
Like I like chicken and rice because it has like, I usually like yellow rice more than white rice, because yellow rice is more has like more flavor into it. if you want to make yellow rice, you have to put the rice in. When it gets like a little like big, mm-hmm. put the mustard in and then stir it and then wait a couple minutes and then it will be yellow.
Hashim, did you know rice. To do that with rice?
No.
I didn't know that either until Santiago told me that yesterday. It blew my mind. I didn't know that you could make, you know, yellow rice like that. That's so cool. Just add some mustard. I didn't know. That's awesome. So now you have told everyone how to do that. So that is fantastic. Santiago, thank you so much for joining us today and then sharing your story and sharing a little bit about your own heritage and that awesome tip about the rice. That is fantastic. Fist bump. Thank you, Santiago. All right, so let's see. We have talked about Hispanic Heritage Month. We've talked about GG. I've talked about academic adventuring. I could have sworn that there was something else. I could have sworn. I don't know. Hashim, is there anything I'm forgetting?
Joke of the day.
Joke of the day! Okay, perfect. I'm glad that you reminded me about joke of the day. Because joke of the day, you're gonna be the one to announce joke of the day. But before we actually do that, going back to that friendship piece that we talked about at the beginning and why you're being celebrated, you know, what advice can you give to the students of Maple Shade on how to be a good friend?
If somebody's ever alone or feeling kind of down, always remember to put yourself in their shoes and try to reach out to them and help them.
Oh my God, I just want to let you all know, I did not ask him this beforehand. That answer just came like that to him. And that shows me, Hashim, that you absolutely believe that, that you own that, that that's important. And we need more people like you in this world to make sure that we have good, solid friendships and healthy friendships out there. So that's great. Keep being you, buddy. You're doing great. Okay, now, joke of the day. Take it away.
Why did the Headless Horseman get a job?
Why did the Headless Horseman get a job?
Because he wanted to get ahead in life.
What a great joke! He wanted to get ahead! That's great! Hashim, thank you so much! Santiago, thank you so much! Everyone, you have worked so hard this week. I know that we only had 4 days together. You know, me being home on Monday, I was so sad that I wasn't here. But I am so happy that I got to spend 4 days with you. And I'm so glad that we have a traditional weekend this week because we'll be back together next week for 5 full days together of academic adventuring, being good friends, and then demonstrating being our best selves at all times. So don't forget, work hard, be academic adventurers. With academic adventuring, it means that we work hard, we work through the challenges, and we have fun. And while we're at it, let's have fun twice.